Boogie, drop that beat. Hi everyone, welcome to my channel, Talking Out Loud with Miss Talkative. Everything I say is my own opinion, alleged, and strictly entertainment purposes. Remember, I'm just talking out loud. Please like, share, subscribe. Comment on the video, let me know what you think. Now, I just watched the first preview of the first part of the reunion for Love and Marriage Huntsville, and let me just get my take. First off, Tisha's dress is still the worst that I've seen from the cast so far, and she's sitting up there acting like she bringing it. It's like she's doing too much. Somebody got her overhyped or something like that, but she should have brought a trash bag, in my opinion, to put that dress in as soon as the reunion is over, because that dress was horrible. I mean, I don't. Every time I look at that dress, it's horrible. Tisha should have kept that robe on, because that dress, it gave every bit of elementary school girl dress up. And Stormy and Courtney, from what I can see, I couldn't see their whole attire, but from what I can see, they look like the Pepto-Bismol twins. On their first confessional that they did for Love and Marriage Huntsville, Courtney had on a gold suit that Stormy was bragging about, that it was real and it was specially made for him or something. And I'm like, okay, well, what happened to the gold suit, Courtney? I would have preferred him to do a repeat of the Aladdin suit versus this mess. Like, no. They outfit, I haven't seen all of it, but from the little bit that I was able to see, it looked like it was an epic fail as well. And it's like, but I could be wrong, because I didn't get a chance to see the whole attire. But anyway, Kimmy, she was looking like she is the head madam that has to pick the ladies to service her husband around the clock to feed his sex cravings throughout the day. I mean, I'm like, what is she like? She's at a costume party or something. Kimmy Ho attire, again, they were sitting down, but from what I see, her attire was an epic fail as well. And I'm like, who dressed these doggone people? I'm like, I'm not seeing anything that I liked besides, you know, Melody sitting up there. Marcel, you know, he plain suit Marcel. Maurice, he still looked like he finna, you know, work at the morgue or something. But their outfits was horrible. I'm like, can they, they always keep saying they got money. Why they can't get a stylist? These dresses are, they not hitting. And Tisha and Marcel, I don't even think they even tried to stand out and match or anything like that. But like I say, it was an epic fail on the attire. Like I say, I did like Nell's outfit that I seen, and from the clips that they shown prior, and I like Melody's outfit. That's it. But anyway, it seems as though somebody, whether it be Wanda, Marcel, whomever it may be, studies the Love and Marriage Huntsville show for Tisha, and they go over the reads with Tisha. It seems like Tisha is not able to read quick like she does all season long. People are getting the best of Tisha, and Tisha is sitting up there taking it. She only can say stuff in the privacy of her and Kimmy, or the privacy of her and Marcel or something like that. Tisha cannot read, not at all. Tisha can go below the belt and say stuff, but Tisha cannot do reads. So in my opinion, somebody is doing the reading for Tisha. They are binge watching the show, and they're going over lines and reads and stuff with Tisha, because Tisha, her whole MO is to run out of the scene or tell people what she's not talking about, or, you know, trying to make people feel sorry for her. So y'all can miss me with the whole saving it for the reunion crap, or what's that saying she was saying, I'm nice until I'm not. Nah, somebody help Tisha with these lines, with these reads. But Stormy nor the Scotts pay bills, so I don't get how Tisha is able to sit up there and try to read Stormy about not paying invoices. I'm like, neither one of y'all pay bills. Aren't the Scotts allegedly known for being scammers in Huntsville? Because on the Zen Garden deposition, it was stated that Marceau has stopped paying their employees that he had recruited to work on the project. So I don't understand how Tisha is trying to read somebody else about not paying bills. She might want to pipe down talking about other people's finances and paying people because their track record ain't so great. And Stormy talking about she gave Tisha grace. How was calling Tisha's husband a B for the basically the whole second half of the season? How's that giving somebody's grace when she's disgracing Tisha by disrespecting her? But that's not, I mean, if that was giving grace, I'd be doggone. But Tisha telling, I assume, which is Kiki, to go take a pill, I think that's lame. I think it's low down and dirty, and I think it's hidden below the belt. It's like Tisha has no shame, just like Marceau. They don't care who they hurt, how low they gotta go to get their point across and make people feel disrespected. It's like you can't read no better than that. Everybody knows that Kiki was addicted to pills, but for you to keep throwing it up in her face, I mean, so in my opinion, this is why Kiki should have been reading them Scotts, all of them, up and down, side to side, left to right, every which way, because Tisha and Marceau, they do not care who is their target. They're going to break them down to the lowest of the lowest. But instead of Kiki reading now, she allowed Tisha to get close to her again and act like they were friends, like they were, you know, becoming family again. And she used Kiki on the first half of the season so Kiki wouldn't be spilling their tea, and you know, they basically can blindside Kiki, and that's what they did. Because on the first half, Tisha was all for being friends with Kiki. None of their stuff got spilled. Kiki was actually even taking up for Tisha and trying to be Tisha's mouthpiece and stuff like that. But oh no, come the second half of the season, Tisha and Marceau, them Scotts, none of them. They didn't want nothing to do with Kiki. Not at all. They wind up having Kiki make a fool of herself and making her herself be discredited. So even if she began talking about their tea, nobody is really listening, because in my opinion, they set her up from the very beginning, because they never wanted her on the show and they didn't want her telling their tea. But they don't have a second thought about telling her tea or whatever, spilling everything that goes on in her household. So this is why Kiki pissed me off, because you keep letting them Scotts get the best of you when you know you already got all the dirt. See, the dirt that they're spilling on Kiki, it doesn't bother Kiki, that she make it seem like it don't bother her. But at the same time, whether it bother me or not, oh, you want to go there? You want to go gutter? Oh, I will show you gutter. It was so many bleeps and this, that, and the other. And what all they did not share on the reunion, it would have been spilled online. I would have been, if I was Kiki, if I had to do a 3-hour live, we would have did a whole timeline and with receipts about the Scott's whole infidelity, everything, because Tisha and Marcel, they're wrong and they're not going to stop until somebody stop them. But I just hope that Kiki got in a few good licks on Tisha. But anyway, Martell, he trying to toot his own horn regarding his manless part. And I'm like, okay, that's an epic fail, because no matter what it looks like, what size it is, if it don't get the job done, it don't get the job done. That's the most important part, right? If Melody says she wasn't pleased in 14 years, then Martell, his stroke game is weak and he's selfish. Because out of 14 years, you couldn't learn to move to the left, move to the right. Your stroke game that bad? Like, don't toot your horn no more. That's why them doggone ladies, that's why you keep breaking up with them ladies. It ain't because you want to. It's that they didn't give you too many chances to get the stroke right. But anyway, Kimmy and Maurice, they the biggest letdowns ever to me. They're supposed to be career people. But yet, all they have to speak on is their sex life, their non-less sex life, what they want their sex life to be like, why they not having sex. If they don't be quiet about sex, can they go to Pornhub with this mess? Because I'm tired of hearing about it. I mean, I know this union, this reunion is... you know, all the cast members are supposed to make it to the reunion. But in my opinion, these two could have just been skipped over. Why send them a plane ticket to talk about nothing? They could have still got a check for the reunion and not even been there. And I promise you, I wouldn't have been mad, because I mean, hell, that's what they do all season. They get a free check along with the rest of their family on the show. But anyway, y'all, it seems like we're going to have some things to talk about after the reunion starts to air. But I'm tuned in as usual for, you know, all the reads, whoever got read or whatever. I just hope that somebody put the Scots in their place. I hope and pray somebody put them Scots in their face and in their place. And I hope that this reunion is not being overhyped and then they wind up under delivering once it airs. But anyway, that's just my opinion. I'm just talking out loud. Please like, share, subscribe, comment on the video. Let me know what you think.